Parang matapos na ang exam na natin pag-usapan. Ano, withdrawal na dinawas ko na ng pag-usapan. Sabi niya, kasi nga, ah, hindi, kasi ang ayaw ng natin mangyari is to send a message na just to win the elections, isasantabi natin yung mga paniniwala natin. Sa akin, while I'm open to, I mean, ano yan? Open to anything. Anything for the sake of the country, kailangan isettle lang ang differences na ito. Okay. So in a way, it's not too different from positioning of Riza Ontiveros. But I think, absolutely correct yung sinasabi ni Lenny na, if, first of all, ano pang saysay mo maging opposition kung isasantabi mo lang yung prinsipyo mo para lang may konti kang margin of ano boost for one of the 12 Senate seats na napakahirap sa election cycle na ito. At more importantly, patay ka sa 2028 elections. Wala ka ng credibility as an alternative to the other houses, etc. So my point si Lenny, I think the bigger relevance nevertheless here is Lenny making the statements, and when Lenny makes the statements, it comes with certain level of authority among others. Ako, suggest ko sana better sometimes coordinated yung messaging ni Lenny and Risa. Although in this case, very similar naman yung messaging nila. But I think it's better because let's not forget that technically speaking, it's Risa who's leading the opposition in this election. She's the one overseeing yung campaign nila, Chel, Bam, and Senator Kiko Pangilinan. Not to mention if who knows if Leila and other comes in. Katulad ng sinabi natin nung last time, guys. In principle, I completely see the point of Leila de Lima, maybe two others from the Senate running. So at least mga six, baka hindi na ocho, di ba? Medyo six siguro, that could be, or five or six could be a kind of a magic number this time. And I hope to get at least one or two into the magic 12. No? So I see the value of that. Kaya nga sabi ko, napakamahalaga na sa election na ito, the genuine opposition will prove talaga na genuine talaga sila. Na hindi lang sila opposition dahil hindi sila nagkaroon ng position sa government. Alright, although some would say na may mga dilawan who ended up in the cabinet. Ibang usapan yan. But as far as the genuine opposition goes, they have to show how genuine they are. Because clearly, pagdating sa mga Dutertes, hindi sila genuine opposition. Unity team sila. At parati ko sinasabi, walang karapatan magreklamo yung ibang DDS dyan dahil ginusto niyan. Kayo ang kasama sa unity team. Kayo ang nag-enable kay BBM. Well, except he turned out even better than Digong. Way better than Digong. But nevertheless, kayo ang nagpabalik na mga Marcoses sa Malacanang. Kasalanan nyo yan. Kayo nag-enable dyan. Nung election, nung sinasabi ko, oh, kung BBM yan, I always said, on foreign policy, I think he'll be okay. But, you know, we can have a long conversation on all other issues. Can I vouch for his economic policies? Not necessarily, no. Is he fighting corruption strong enough? Seriously? Maharlika Fund? Seriously? Ano nangyari sa agriculture? O, nagsekretary pa siya for a while? O, ano nangyari? Anong improvement sa agriculture sector? Manufacturing? Ano bang industrial policy niya so far? Alright? So yes, I'll give him siguro passing grade, more than passing grade sa foreign policy, West Philippine Sea, especially going around. But at the end of the day, it's about what you deliver at home. Anong ginawa mo sa inflation? Anong ginawa mo sa economic growth? Anong ginawa mo sa fighting corruption? Nagkaroon ba ng accountability dun sa pagkamatay ni Percy Lapid? Nagkaroon ba ng accountability dun sa mga EJK nangyari? Eh hanggang ngayon, ang positioning BBM is we will not cooperate with ICC if ever magkaroon ng warrants of arrest. So how are we improving the human rights situation there? Kaya hindi ko rin naintindihan yung mga puting ambassadors mga yan, tuwan-tuwa ka sa kanila. No, but what has he delivered on the human rights front or fighting corruption in a systematic way? Right? So, dun sa mga kaibigan natin na DDS, sinong nagpanalo sa mga Marcoses? Kayo. Kayo ang kasama. Kayo ang kasama sa unit team. So, ngayon, hindi nyo nakuha yung gusto nyo. At yung problema nyo yan. You made the gamble. Tuloy. Diba? Di pa kayo kasama sa mga F1 Grand Prix niya. Oh, sorry na lang. Di daw kayo ano eh. Diba? Kasalanan nyo yan eh. Kasalanan nyo yan. So, I'm just saying, wala karapatan magreklamo mga DDS. Eh, kayo nga kasama sa unit team. And then please, stop quoting. Mali pa nga yung quotation niyo. Obviously na hindi niyo alam yung basic grammar niyo. Magka-quote pa nga kayo sa akin. Mali-mali pa yung grammar ng quotation niyo. Dahil hindi naman tinitwist niyo yung sinasabi ko. But anyway, I did say that at some point, Sarah was the top contender. to be the president. That's true. That's a fact. Look at the Pulse Asia surveys in second and even third quarter of 2021. That's a fact. Was the SARO the major mobilizing force? Yes, yes. Pero tapos na yun. That's 2020. That's so 2022. Tapos na yan. It's over. Tapos na yan. Wala na, wala na, wala na. Now, gusto mong sasabihin ni Supra Analyst na may magic pa rin ng mga Duterte. Yeah, they may have enough magic to be one of the dynasties there and maybe have a one or two senators. Yeah, I'm not saying. But wala na yung anong dati. Wala na yun. Wala na yun. But still, one heartbeat away lang yung isa sa presidency. But all I'm saying here is, sa genuine opposition, you have to prove that you're genuine. And you have to accept na talo kayo ng 2016, except kay Lenny, medyo nakalusot. Talo kayo ng 2019, even worse. Talo na naman kayo sa 2020, nakalusot all those si Risa. Also in 2016 din si Risa. Sana 2025, kausapin yung mga voters at tanong nyo, bakit ayaw nyo na sa kinagawa namin or ayaw nyo na sa platforma namin? Bakit being a liberal is a pejorative term in Philippine politics right now? Bakit laughingstock na ang Liberal Party? Dapat, you figure that out in this election. Para, pagdating sa 2020 elections, may pag-asa na kayo. Kasi, there could be redemption. In politics, as in life, as in spiritual life, you can have redemption, but redemption doesn't come unless there's recognition and repentance. And that recognition and repentance has to be ano pa, kailangan pa masayanan, medyo kulang, to put it mildly, right? Now, go ahead, hate me, ang dami itong mga dilawan na nakakainis, mga trolls na ganun-ganun, tapos gumagawa pa ng Marites in HSRN pala niya, pinapaaway pa ako kay Christian Esquerra na parang competition. No, it's not. I'm not competing against anyone. I'm competing against myself, right? I'm competing against other global thinkers who have also opened up their vlogging, etc. You know, I have friends in Indonesia who have a million followers on YouTube, for instance, and doing fantastic vlogs and podcasts on global affairs, right? I have friends in the US, in Europe, who also have huge vlogs and they're also experts, professors. They bring other experts on. Yun ang mga competition ko, guys. So alam ko yung mga iba, nag-echosera lang, pinapaaway-away kami dahil may axe to grind sila, dahil pinoint out ko yung mga ano nila, elitismo nila, sa mga kaiwanan nila, mga lahat ng mga ganyan. So anyways, if opposition were to have a chance in 2028, guess what? There has to be a politics of redemption, and there'll be no policy of redemption if there's no recognition and there's no repentance and there is no coming to terms dun sa mga kakulangan na nangyari in the past. On that note, thank you very much. Mabuhay kayo, mga kaubayan natin. For all the jokes I make or all yung mga kantsawan na ginagawa natin sa ating mga kasama na whether DDS, lawyers, whatever, or even I say dilawan, at the end of the day, alam ko naman lahat tayo in our own ways we love our country. Eh. Yun lang, dapat magkakaroon tayo ng tamang pag-intindi sa mga bagay-bagay at hindi natin parating sisisihin yung ibang tao pag hindi natin nakukuha yung gusto natin. Alright? So it's very, very important, guys, na we get some basic things right here, okay? And learn to work together. But that will only start, guys, if we have these kinds of conversation. And look at it, guys. I'm real. I'm sitting here, no notes, no script, no production. Oh, kita niyo yung eyebags ko, lahat na, wala, no pretension whatsoever. What you're seeing here is a translucent, essentially, reflection of my state of mind and my understanding of Philippine politics. All right, no pacute, no PowerPoint, no script, no production whatsoever. All right, this is what we do. We keep it real. Now, of course, may mga production stuff din ako, but because I have to do it, it's part of my work. But in these lives na ginagawa natin, di na nakita na ito yung totoo, ito yung talagang pag-iintindi ko sa mga bagay-bagay. And in personal conversation, I'm also like this, just as passionate and just as sure. Although, of course, maybe slightly less current. Alright, but you get my point. On that note, thank you very much, guys. Maraming salamat. Oh, hindi na ako na-clickbait. I still went to the final thing on the part of Lenny. So, we went back. So, I did exactly as I promised. Alright, nag-deliver tayo sa promise natin. Thank you so much again, guys, for all your support, continued support. Tuloy-tuloy ng support. Now, thank you. We got, I think, additional 50 ratings dun sa Spotify natin over the past month or so. So, sana tuloy-tuloy lang yan. We want to have at least 1,000 ratings and hopefully closer to 5-star than not. dun sa Spotify natin, Deep Dive with Richard Hidarian. Also the same on Apple Podcast. Sa Apple Podcast, medyo nakakulang tayo. So I hope tuloy-tuloy lang yung pag-support nyo doon, pag-subscribe nyo doon, and also rate us so that lalabas yung ratings natin. Medyo maganda naman ratings natin, thank God. Alright, so tuloy-tuloy lang yan. And of course, continue to support us and subscribe us. Subscribe to us, and of course, continue to support dun sa mga ibang kasama natin who are also doing the right thing, fighting the good fight. Let me congratulate, si Dem Josh ba yan? Sorry, I hope I get the name right. Kanilang kinongratulate ko siya because he's one of the first unabashedly pink vloggers out there who unabashedly stands for all the good things that the pink movement stands for and unabashedly supports the good things that Rizza Ontiveros and other progressive leaders stands for. Nauna pa siya sa amin, I think, and Christian dun sa YouTube. Alright, so Christian has been a journalist for a long time. I've been also doing what I've been doing for quite a long time. So wala kami sa YouTube for a long time, huh? YouTube, 2 years lang ako medyo active sa YouTube, to be honest, diba? So if you look at bulk of my, 95% of my uploads are just the past 2 years. Practically coterminous dun sa Spotify account podcast ako natin, which is roughly also 2 years old, right? So good luck and congratulations dun sa mga ibang pink, progressive vloggers who have provided a counterbalance dun sa mga, for lack of better term, di ba? The whole adulteration of the information space na ginawa ng mga iba, di ba? Yung mga bulljack type, yung mga ganyan types, di ba? Or whatever. There are even worse types na not even worth mentioning, right? But having said that, of course, I hope we support also other people who may not be pink, who may be a bit conservative, a bit right-wing, or whatever, but also love our country and are fighting for West Philippine Sea, fighting against the worst that the Duterte's represent among others. And also, we welcome and support yung mga ibang ex-DDS or medyo DDS na hindi na, diba? Please, you're welcome. You're welcome to join us in nation building beyond partisanship and beyond defending isang morally bankrupt former authoritarian strongman leader who was so incompetent he couldn't even become a dictator despite his best wishes. On that note, thank you very much. God bless and talk to you soon. Maraming salamat. Mabuhay ang Pilipinas.